Welcome friends, we are here at Google Developer Days India and we have with us today Wayne, who is a developer advocate at Google. Hi Wayne.
Hi.
How has been your experience with GDD India?
It's been a lot of fun. I mean, we've had a great time here. It's been really good to see all the developers here who are really excited about the IoT and Android things and all that kind of stuff that we do. So it's been really cool to sort of see the energy here. It's been really exciting.
Super nice. For those who missed your session, can you give us a quick summary?
Well, I gave two talks. I gave one summary talk that sort of talks about everything Google's doing to support developers everywhere. So we talked about IoT devices, Internet of Things, Android things, Assistant, the Assistant SDK, TensorFlow, Firebase, how to bring it all together, because we want to encourage people to make apps that sort of solve all kinds of problems in all kinds of different places.
What are some cool use cases for IoT devices?
I mean, IoT devices are interesting because we're going to be able to embed into everything. And so it's going to open up all kinds of possibilities to bring computing to places where we've never been able to do it before. There are people out there who don't know how to read or write, maybe. They can't use a phone, they can't use a laptop. And so people are going to be able to speak to their computers and listen to them. And people who have disabilities will be able to, you know, interact with computers as well. So it's going to really create new opportunities for developers and, you know, really solve really important problems for people.
So Wayne, for the developers who want to get started with Google Assistant, which are some best resources that you would recommend?
So our developer platform for the Assistant is called Actions on Google. And the best way to get started with that is using a tool called Dialogflow. You basically write a bunch of example sentences for your conversation, and it uses machine learning to help process them to deal with the conversations that happen later. Now, if you don't want to do any programming at all, you can actually use our actions templates where you simply fill in a form, and then you program in the questions and answers and different parts of the conversation, and it generates all of it for you. So there's many different options depending on what you want to do, and that's a really great way to get started getting things working on the Google Assistant.
Make sure you check out all of these resources. Thanks a lot for being with us, Wayne.
Hey, thanks. It's my pleasure.